Yes, and do you know, yesterday I was communicating with someone, and the argument was that in certain cultures and right now in certain countries as well, when looking for a spouse for your daughter, what they say is, we want someone who has at least a house and a car and a good job and whatever. You know what? I think that if you're prepared to sacrifice with a responsible human being who has deen and akhlaq, I think you stand a better chance of raising a much better, more responsible family than you would if you looked for a person at the age of 20, in their 20s, who already has everything. It's problematic. You've minimized your numbers, the chances of you getting a spouse who's amazing human being are less, because you've just cut the numbers down and now you're looking for someone who has wealth already. And this is the biggest difference I found with our generations and the ones of our fathers and perhaps grandfathers, where when they married, they actually built a life together and they actually started at zero. Because the man was responsible, the woman was responsible, they fulfilled their roles. They then got, they lived in rented accommodation for long. Some people die in
That's
rented
true.
accommodation.
That's true.
The bulk
Yeah,
of the
that's
world,
true.
actually, the majority of the world doesn't, I mean, don't, they don't own a house. So it's not like you need to own it, but unfortunately, parents are making a mistake. And it's not like you need to have a car, you need to have everything. For as long as the youngster's responsible, comes from a decent upbringing, and he has deen and character, and for as long as the way of thinking is more or less in sync with your child, I think that that would make a much better spouse than someone who might just have materialistic belongings and nothing beyond that.